Hi guys, and welcome back. Today I'm gonna do a get ready with me, but first, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and then so you'll be alerted to my videos when I upload them. If you've been with me, thank you for subscribing, thank you for watching, thank you for interacting with me, and for participating in the last giveaway. Stay tuned because there is a super awesome giveaway to come. I can't even believe that I've passed 100 subscribers. I know that's not a lot to some people, but to me, it's a lot and it means a lot. I love when you guys suggest different videos, and I really do try my best to do the video that that you want. So for those of you who have been with me, some of you have asked, the elephant in the room. While we were in Hawaii, I got a tattoo and it says no greater love, and it's John 13:15, and the whole verse is there's no greater love than to lay your life down for a friend. And that is my absolute favorite Bible verse because it's just so sweet and so tender to my heart. So anyways, this is going to be a long get ready with me. If you want to get ready with me, grab all your makeup. It doesn't have to be a Naked Heat palette. Just grab a palette, grab your makeup, grab your stuff, and you can sit down and we can get ready together, because I promise you, like, there's hardly anything cut out. But if you just want to sit, watch, and listen, because I talk a lot, grab a cup of coffee. Grab an iced coffee, grab whatever your favorite drink is and a snack, and yeah, let's get started with the video. All right, so let's get ready. If you see those blue pieces of tape, my beauty room is under construction. My husband is actually gonna be putting up some shelves for me so I can kind of just have more space to put stuff, because my beauty room isn't that big. And so after I kind of get it squared away, I'll give you guys like a little tour of it. It's in one of my other videos. It's not going to be its own video because it's not very big, but I actually got a couple additions to my beauty room. My sister-in-law made me that sign. It says Jan's Beauty Room. How cute is that? And then she also made me those flowers right there. So so yeah, but I will give you a tour of the room as soon as it like comes together. So I feel like I'm crooked. Am I crooked? Okay. All right, so first we're gonna start off with foundation, and I'm gonna use the Lancôme Tint d'Idol. I am in the color Bisque 260. It's a little bit light. I bought it actually before we went to Hawaii. And I think this is actually my winter color. However, I've used all my other makeup, and the only one that I have is this one. And that makes me look super glowy. I feel like it has a natural glow. And honestly, I like more of a matte look. If you're in a tropical climate, it's okay. But so when I'm using my beauty blender, this is an actual beauty blender. I'm excited to try the Flower. Well, it's the Beauty Sponge by Flower. And that company is by Drew Barrymore, and she is so cute. I love her in like all her movies, especially with Adam Sandler. So I do want to try her sponge because it's, I believe it's like half the price of the beauty blender. And yeah, I heard it works really good, so I want to try that. You know, if you didn't have concealer, like for your under eye, before I didn't really need concealer, but now that I'm 46, like all of a sudden I need concealer. That's so ugly, right? So even though this is not my favorite, the Tarte Shape Tape, I'm gonna use just a little bit today, just because I don't want it to go bad. So see, I didn't use a lot at all. When I'm talking and doing my makeup, sometimes I feel like I forget what I'm doing and I may not do it right. So please forgive me. This is Jenny in real life. So this is real life and I do forget a lot of stuff. So yeah. Sometimes I just bring the concealer. I just bring it up over my eye. Like if I have a lot of concealer, but today I didn't use a lot of concealer. So I'm just gonna go in with my eye primer. And of course, what did I do with it? Okay, I'm thirsty. I drink a lot of water. If I'm at home, I'm constantly drinking water and I refill my cup, and I like cold water. So this is the Urban Decay Primer Potion in Even. So I'm just gonna blend that in with my sponge. You could also blend it in with your finger just as easily. But I'm just gonna go ahead and use my sponge or my blender. So I had so much fun doing the giveaway. It truly is, like, I don't know how many times, like, I've entered lots of like contests before or giveaways and really have never won anything, and really not expecting to, like, and then you're like, does anybody really win those things? Like, you never hear like of someone winning. But it was so fun. And it was like, it was exciting. And to have an actual person like pop up as the winner, and I got to email her and talk to her, and it was so fun. Like, I got so much joy in packing it, and I sent it priority mail because I wanted to get to her right away. It was just super exciting. So I'm gonna use my IT Cosmetics Brow Power in Universal. So I really like this one. I'm almost out. The only thing is, if you don't use it like right away, it will get stale. It'll get hard, and it gets hard and stale and it won't work anymore. So it's hard to look in here and do my makeup. I need a mirror. So I've been thinking about like the videos that I would like to do. And it's kind of scary, because really, like, when you're on YouTube, it's like you're really opening up yourself to people. It's like, really, I never wanted to be bareface like on the internet. It's like, no, it's not something I want. But I've been here bareface, waxing my face. Yeah. So, but it's just so interesting. Now it's like, even though I don't enjoy coming on bareface, it's not as hard as it was initially. And then, like, talking to the camera it becomes easier at first. It's like, oh gosh, I hope nobody hears me. But I do have a sign on my door that says, filming in progress. So the boys, which my husband and my sons know that if that sign is up, that means shh and don't knock on my door and kill me. Then I'm going to use some Gimme Brow. I know some people are probably saying, well, you have full eyebrows, you know, what are you doing? And I do have a lot of hair on my eyebrows, but there are some sparse areas and I just like to shape them up so they look more like they're the same. I have two of the same eyebrows. And just gonna put a little bit, this is actually, I hardly have any left, so I do need to get a brow, a new, like full size brow. If you've tried anything, like I'm not necessarily married to this one, so if there's like a brow mascara that you like that holds these babies in place and adds color, let me know in the bottom bar, because I'll probably try it. So I have a couple videos coming up. I have an Allure and Sephora Play unboxing, which I think is gonna be super fun. I'm really excited. I haven't opened either of them. I got them like over a week ago. So I have been dying to, so I'm gonna put some pencil. It's called the Brow Gal. So I'm gonna put it underneath kind of like as a highlighter. And I actually got this in my Allure box. So it's got two sides, and one's like a, it says new toffee, and then this is just like a highlighter cream color. But I've used this one on my brow, but it's like too, I don't know, it's too light. But I'm sure you could use it, or I could use it as like a contour, a light contour or something, which I don't do a lot of. I mean, let's be real, like I'm not a beauty guru, honestly. Like I take pride in taking care of my skin and putting on makeup, and I do wear eyeshadow, but like I'm not one of those girls that do like the smoky eyes and the winged eyeliner. Like I would love to do that, and I'm sure one day I will, but until I learn how to do that, you're gonna see how I really do my makeup. And I think that's why I called my channel Jenny in Real Life, is because this is real life. Like, you know, I'm not gonna show you something that I don't do or that I don't like, or make a video because it's popular on YouTube. Like, it's taken me a long time to grow my channel. I'm not doing anything crazy, and it's just gonna, it grows when it grows. Okay. So now that we have our eyes prepped, what do I want to do? I think let's warm up the face a little bit and then we'll do the eyeshadow. So I'm going to use my Mariah Carey bronzer, and it's called In My Mimi. I'm gonna be doing a drugstore haul. I haven't gone to the drugstore yet, but there's a lot of L'Oreal products that I've been wanting to try, as well as the butter bronzers, and I forgot who they were by. Shoot, is it Neutrogena? I don't remember, but for some more affordable stuff, including a foundation. So I'm really excited about that, because I love both drugstore and high-end makeup. I just like it all. I don't discriminate. Like, it's all makeup, right? Unless it's really, like, I have problems with 99-cent store makeup. I don't know why. I just do. Anyways. Okay. So we're going to start with the Naked Heat palette. And so I'm working with the bare bones of brushes because I need to wash all my brushes. So, yeah. So this is a very old Bare Minerals crease brush. And I'm gonna use Chaser. It's very light. It's this one right here. And I'm just gonna put that kind of in the crease and kind of bring it up. And just, if you have this palette, or you're thinking about getting this palette, it does have a lot of kickback and fallout. It doesn't bother me, but I just thought I'd let you know so that you're aware of that. The eyeshadows are still beautiful and they blend out beautifully. So we're just gonna put that in the crease. You know, I wanted to try that, like where you put tape right here. But I don't know, maybe that's for another video. I always just fix it with concealer because I'm messy. Is anyone else messy with makeup or with their eyeshadow? Like that, I think that's the only thing that I'm messy with. And like with this color, it's called Chaser. Like you don't have to be super perfect because it is light. It may look a little bit dark on me, but it's light. Well, it does look dark. I may have had something else on this brush. Okay, so you know what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do also at the same time, I'm gonna put it underneath the lash line. So we'll just grab a little bit and put it underneath the lash line. So I have, I'm also gonna do, so I told you I was gonna do the unboxings and then I'm gonna do a story time of when I met Angela Johnson, and it's kind of a funny story. I really embarrassed myself. So I'm gonna do that as well. Okay, so with the same brush, I'm gonna pick up the next color, which is Sauced, okay? And we're gonna put that like just directly into the crease. I'm not gonna bring it up like I did the other color. I had a request to do a skincare video and I really want to. I just, like right now I'm using like just miscellaneous to wash my face, but I'm using the Lancôme like moisturizers and eye cream. That's what I'm using right now. But I'm still on the hunt for like a serious like medical grade like skincare routine, because I'd like to get rid of, see, I have some sunspots right there, which I didn't put a lot of foundation on because I could cover those actually. So I really would like to get rid of that and then tighten up this right here. You know, when you gain weight and you lose weight, you gain weight and you lose weight, it's like the elasticity and your skin goes away. So we're gonna put Sauced on the other side as well, right there in the corner or like in exactly in the crease. So and then we're just gonna also take that underneath the lash line. So this is the second time that I'm filming a Get Ready With Me. The first time I bought a camera off eBay. It's the Canon T4i. And I'm still learning how to do all this stuff. It's not easy. I mean, literally, especially when you do everything yourself, you're filming, you're like setting up the camera, you're doing lighting, you have to make sure you're in focus. Then you film the tutorial. You have to make sure the camera doesn't shut off. You have to prepare everything, and then you have to upload it after that and then edit it. It's a lot of work, especially when you're a one-woman show. So, okay, we got that done. Okay, it looks like it's like dragging right here, but like I said, we're gonna clean it up. So if you're messy, it's okay. And I'm saying that to myself because sometimes I expect myself to be like on point, but seriously, like who is? Okay, so okay, what? Oh, all right. So we're gonna do Lumbre right here on the lid, and it is like a rose gold, yeah, color. So we're going to put that on the lid, and I'm going to use this little generic brush. Actually, I'm not going to use this one. I'm going to use the Real Techniques. What is this called? It's called a shading brush, but I'm going to use it to put that on my lid. Hang on. Okay, so I am going to spray it a little bit with my Super Goop Rose Mist Setting Spray. Let's see if you can see that. Okay. It's super awesome. I love this because it's moisturizing. It's it has rosemary. Anyways, and it's SPF 50. I love it. So I actually used that on the plane going to and from Hawaii because, you know, the cabin has recirculated air, and this is the first time I think that my face and my lips got like super tight and dry, so that definitely saved me. All right, so let's put this on the lid. I thought it would come out like darker, especially because I sprayed the brush, but I mean, it's still pretty. You can still see it. Let me try to make it a little bit darker. What do you guys think about doing a hooded eye tutorial? Because I have hooded eyes. So see, when you like open up your eye, it's like, this is like kind of heavy and you lose a lot of your lid, as opposed to those girls who have eyes like this and like have a lot of lid space. I don't know, let me know what you think. Yeah. All right, so we're gonna just continue on. I'm not gonna put this underneath the lash line though, just because it's like shiny and goldy. I don't really want this underneath my lash line. So you can see that looks really good, like nice color. All right, so should we deepen it up a little bit? Like, I'm wondering if we should do He Devil or Cayenne. Okay. This is all we're doing, and I'm going to do this super light because I'm afraid that it's going to come out all. So this is He Devil. So I'm going to use a little bit of that. And what am I going to use? This brush right here. Generic brush. That sucks that all my go-to brushes are dirty. Sorry about that. So if you have any suggestions for tutorials, if you have suggestions for skincare, just leave them down below in the comments. Kind of a maroony color. I always have trouble doing the outer corner of my right eye. Do you guys have that same problem? I'm just kind of putting it like, kind of dab it up like that because it's dark and I just want it like on the very edge, and then just bring it in a little bit, and then we're gonna blend that out. Use my MAC 224 blending brush. This probably needs to be washed. Okay, so I'm just gonna blend. Let's blend the other side. Holy cow, guys, this is gonna be a long video. I hope you're ready. What about makeup palettes? What makeup palettes are you loving? High-end, Morphe, Sigma, like low-end, NYX. What are you loving? Let me know. Because I want to know. All right, so we put that there, and then I'm going to put a little bit of the He Devil underneath the lash line as well, and I'm going to use this Real Techniques brush, but I think the name of it wiped off. Perfect. I know. So Sorry if I'm like. Also, if you got this palette, like, what do you think about the palette? I know it is super warm. It is a super warm palette, but I really enjoy it. I'm going to now, I'm going to clean up a little bit. So I'm going to put a little bit of concealer on my hand and use it as a palette. And gonna do this night. And that. All right. Okay. Let's do the lashes. Okay, we're gonna use my trusty eyelash curler from Sephora. You guys know the drill. I have probably bored you to tears with telling you how much I love this eyelash curler. It is amazing. And if you haven't got this eyelash curler, like, what are you doing with your life? I don't know. Seriously. I'm just kidding. But maybe this will be in my next giveaway. The next giveaway is going to be freaking awesome. Okay. L'Oreal Voluminous Base. Yes, please. Why do we make such weird faces when, like, doing the mascara thing? So weird. You see how that looks? And you just leave it just like that. I seriously need a new one. Is starting to get warm in here because I left the AC off, so there's no background noise, but geez Louise. Okay, I'm just gonna use my sample Dior Show mascara. I'm not buying any mascara right now because I have a ton of samples and I am not one to waste. So I will use what I have, unless I really hate it. Then, But if it does the job and it works well with my L'Oreal Voluminous Primer, then I'm gonna rock it. You know what I'm saying? I got mascara right here. All right. And then on the bottom, I'm going to use my CoverGirl Clump Crusher. And I'm sure I told you before, I have long eyelashes even on the bottom. So if I use something that's, thick and voluminous, I'm gonna look like I have false lashes on the bottom. Like it's gonna look too dramatic. And I like this because it like coats, separates. I'm just, not about that life. So I use this one and it works. All right. So this is not a million years long. I am going to speed things up. I'm going to use a drugstore Milani blush in Rose d'Oro. Rose d'Oro is super pretty. And I'm just gonna use a very light hand with this blush. That looks dark, right? Let's see. Sometimes it looks dark there, but here it's not dark. See, here it's not all that dark. That's what I hate about filming. Because when you do makeup, sometimes it doesn't always translate, or it translates wrong. You know what I'm saying? I forgot to put on. Also thinking about doing a Q and A, but I have to figure out how that is going to work. I'm really getting hot, people. Okay. Highlight. ¿Dónde está mi highlight? Okay. You know the drill. Laura Geller. Gilded Honey. Do you guys like this? Because if you do, I may include this as well. I like it. I think it's perfect. Although I do have some other stuff to try. I have one by Becca that I need to try. So, I think it's, I don't know if it's in Moonstone. I don't know. All right. Did I just highlight my whole upper lip instead of just the Cupid's bow? Get it together. You ever talk to yourself? I do all the time. And I don't call myself Jenny, I call myself Jennifer because I'm mad at myself. Okay, let's do the lips. And we're going to take down the hair and then we'll be done. Okay. So I think this could do two lipsticks. When is the Smashbox? We'll do two lips. Or, well, since I did the Urban Decay Naked Palette, I'm going to do the Metalized Heat. And since I'm not lazy. Okay, I'm going to use the Makeup Forever Aqua Lip Pencil in 8C. You guys know I'm all about them lip liners. And you know lip liners keep your lipstick from bleeding, right? And that means going up into the lines of like any wrinkles or up into your lip or your lower lip. So just in case you didn't know. Because some people don't. All right. Let's put on this lip. All right, I'm gonna take down my hair and I'll be right back. Don't move. All right, you guys, so this is the finished look. I took down my hair. And so this is the look that I came up with. I hope you like it. It looks pretty like, I don't know, heat-y to me, if that's a word. We use the Urban Decay Naked Heat palette. Let me know what you think. I know it's not super dramatic, but hey, it's super wearable. I love the lip. And so yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this get ready with me, and this chatty get ready. Sorry it was so long. Let me know if you like it. Let me know if next time it's like, cut that short. So anyhow, until next time, don't forget to subscribe before you leave, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.